Hi, I'm old man Steve, and when I'm not hunting bear in Sugar Grove or deer in Elburn, I'm at home watching TV 17 Outdoors.
Everybody, Terry Wido here with Gary Levitt on camera. Big game tonight, little 10 game between Leland-Earlville and the home team Hinckley-Big Rock Royals. Both teams struggling a little bit this year. For the Royals, their record is 3-3, 4-14 overall. Coming back a little bit, they had a real tough beginning. They played all the tough teams in conference, the Newarks and Serenas, and of course Indian Creek. They're led by players like Tate Anderson, Seth Musicanus, Cameron Rupp, and also Jackson Lauer and Taylor Rue. His brother played here a couple years ago. Again, their record's 3-3. Bill Sandbrook is the coach. For Leland-Earlville, their record is 8-11. Their coach is Brad McGill. 1-4 in conference. They lost the other night a tough game to Samanok. And they're led by, remember from last year, Joey Avilas. Also, they've got Bryce Abbott, Grant Campbell. Remember those guys from last year. Again, their record is 1-4. Hinckley-Big Rock 3-3. We'll be back with the opening lineups right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Shift into savings now at your local Kubota dealer. Kubota's RTVX series is the best-selling diesel utility vehicle in the industry, earning their place by setting the standard for being durable and reliable under all kinds of conditions. Right now, you can get long-term financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years on new Kubota RTVX utility vehicles. See your local Kubota dealer today.
We're back at Hinckley-Big Rock High School. Let's do our opening lineups. Starting for Leland-Earlville, number one, Joey Avila. Remember him from last year. We have number 12, and I don't have a number 12. Number zero, I have him. That's Logan Stralka. Number 11, Bryce Abbott. Remember him from last year. And number 31, Brennan Sweeney, coached by Brad McGill, record of 8-11. Now for Hinckley-Big Rock. All right, now for the Royals. All right, first starter is number 10, Coda Gum. Number 14, Jackson Lauer. Number 25, that's Tate Anderson. And number two, Jacob Musicanus. And his brother, number 23, Seth Musicanus. Royals coached by Bill Sandbrooks, record of 4-14, and we'll be back right after this on TV 17.
20 years, Pegs on Main Street in Maple Park has provided quality professional hair care for the entire family. Peg and her staff keep up on the latest fashion trends for adults and children. She also carries a wide variety of hair care products for your convenience. And when they're finished pampering your hair, you can walk over and browse around the fantastic on-site gift shop. Stop in anytime at Pegs on Main in downtown Maple Park or give them a call at 815-827-3051.
And we're back. Hinckley-Big Rock. Opening tip-off taken by number one, Aviles. Passing it around. We'll try to get number 12 for you. Don't have his name just yet. Aviles back with the ball. And we got a camera right in front of us. From Bryce Abbott. Abbott going to drive in. Block. Nice block there by Seth Misukanis. Knocks it out of bounds. Abbott can inbound it, and that shot was off to the side and grabbed there. Number 10, Coda Gum, grabs the rebound. Shot from the corner, three-point shot off, saved there by the Royals. Moving the ball around. 25, Tate Anderson calls out a play. Anderson will drive in, his shot hard off the iron. Rebound taken back, big number zero. Nice pass underneath, but it gets it back. Thought about the three-pointer. Aviles gonna drive, take it to the hoop. Can't get it to fall. Rebound grabbed there by Seth Misukanis. Anderson's got it now. Picked up by number 31, Sweeney. And a long shot there. Misukanis with the three-pointer. So Jake gets the first basket. It's a three-point shot. Long shot for three again. That one off the backboard. Grabbed by Anderson. Nice rebound. Got good position. Gonna set things up. Just underway. 6 minutes and 15 seconds left to go here in the first period. Anderson calling out the play. Leland-Earlville on a zone. Another long three-pointer. That one high off the backboard. No good. Nice pass down court to Aviles. Aviles going to drive in and gets an easy layup. Take it back. That was zero. That was Strelka with the basket. Number zero. Anderson going to drive in. Passes it off. A little bumping underneath and rebound grabbed there by Leland-Earlville. Aviles bringing it down, crashes, gets past the timeline. Strelka will take a shot. Off the backboard, no good, and the ball knocked out of bounds. Underneath and okay, Tyler Brech was fouled on that play, so he's going to get a couple free throws. First one's no good, a little bit too strong. Actually, off the front end of the iron. Gets another one, though. Scores 3-2, 5:13 left to go in the first period. Second free throw is up, and that one is good. So Tyler with his first points. Hinckley coming back. Nice drive to the hoop, but Strelka blocked his progress, and looks like he'll pick up a foul. And Gary says it will be a shooting foul, so Strelka picks up his first foul, and Seth Misukanis will get the free throws. 3-3 is our score. And first one's up and good. So Seth has his first point of the game. His brother has a three-point basket. 4-3 is our score. Mm-hmm.
Second free throw, and that one's good. So Seth puts them both, gets them both the drop. And a nice move down underneath, and Bryce Abbott with a nice basket. 5-5. Looks like the ball was on the end line. No, he was fouled. So Sweeney picks up that foul. Second team foul for the Panthers. Royals move the ball around. Anderson, kind of the quarterback out there. A nice drive by Misakanis. They can put it back out. Well, they had the three-point shots. They were open. Anderson driving to the hoop, and he's fouled. A little touch foul there. Number 11, Bryce Abbott with another foul. I believe that's his, no, that's his first. Fourth team foul. Jacob Lauer in the game. There's a three-point shot from the outside. In and out. Halfway down, and it fell out. And a foul underneath there. Cody Gum picks up that foul. 5-5 is our score. 4:14 left to go in the first period of play. Leland moving the ball down good. Vilas with it. Sweeney's got it now. Looking to pass off. Man open in the corner. Three-point shot. It's good. So Bryce Abbott with the three-pointer, and he's fouled. Chance for that very, very rare four-point play that Gary loves to see. Can he make it? No, couldn't convert it. Royals get the rebound. They trail 8-5. Nice move to the hoop and a basket there by Misakanis. This is Seth Misakanis. His first basket. He's got a couple free throws, and it's 8-7. Leland-Earlville loses the ball, taken back there by Seth Misakanis. Passes it off to Gum. Back to Misakanis. Anderson's got it now, picked up by Sweeney. Gum will try to drive. Ooh, passes it and went off the hands. I think he was aiming that pass to Misakanis, but it went off the hands of Anderson. And out of bounds and over to the Leland-Earlville Panthers. Almost knocked away, almost lost the ball. Tight defense there by the Royals. Abbott gets it now, crosses the timeline. Marcus Seviles has it. Back to Abbott. Seviles gets it. He's going to shoot and misses everything. Rebound grab by the Royals. That was Joey that took that shot. Joey Seviles. Nice spin move by Anderson. He's got a man open now. Three-point shot from the corner. That's no good. And number two, that was Misakanis, missed that one. Abbott can drive all the way in, and ball knocked away, but the referee says it's a reach-in foul on number 14, Jackson Lauer. 2:44 that is left to go. 8-7 is our score. Hinckley-Big Rock, one of Gary's favorite places to shoot a game. He says the lighting's here is good. Has a good vantage point. Abbott's free throw is up and good. Bryce with 6 points now, leads all scorers. Second free throw coming up, and that one is, that's good too. And Bryce Abbott, 7 points. Royals coming back. Nice pass underneath and a basket there. Number two, Jake Misakanis. Nice passing there by Leland-Earlville. Back over to Vilas. He's picked up. He's going to try to force a shot up and in. Joey Avilas with his first basket. He's got 2 points now. Anderson, nice pass. There, nice move underneath and a basket. 14. Jackson Lauer, nice move to the hoop and he's fouled. So a chance for Gary's second favorite play, the Hardway three-point play. He loves that four-point play. You only see that once every other game. Abbott couldn't quite convert, but he did hit the three-pointer. 2:06 left to go. 12-11 in favor of Leland-Earlville, but Hinckley with a chance to tie it up on this free throw. And they do. So Jackson Lauer with his third point. 12-12 is our score. Leland-Earlville moving it down court really well. Avila's going to try. Actually, that's his brother Marcus. Couldn't get it. Pretsch had the ball, lost control on the floor. Who's got it? Going to have a held ball? No, they're going to say a travel. Who had it there, Gary? I can't see the number. It's zero. Okay, Logan Stralka called for a travel. He was on the floor trying to get control of the ball. Royals with it now. Near the end of the first quarter, nice pass. Number 11's in the game now for the Royals. And that is Matt Menzel. Gum gonna take it. Puts it up and around, ooh, doesn't fall in. Rebound grabbed by Avilas. He's gonna take it down. Cross the timeline, almost lost the handle, but gets rid of it. Brett's gonna do a little hook shot and up and in. Tyler Bretsch with his third point. Back up 14-12 now are the Panthers. Lauer with it. Gonna pass off. 3-point attempt, and that is high off the backboard, off the rim, I should say. Battle for the ball and a foul. A white number 11, so that's Matt Menzel with the foul. That's his first foul. 15 foul, two more, and actually both teams, two more fouls will be in the bonus. I take it back. Leland's only got four fouls. Leland-Earlville. Moving the ball down. And Joey Avilas over to Marcus. Big number zero, Stralka with it. He passed it off to Joey. And we got a reach in foul. Ask Gary who's it on. So Seth Misakanis picks up the foul. Oh, almost threw it away. They managed to get it back. Avilas, Abbott, nice pass underneath. And oh, he missed an easy layup. Tyler Bretsch probably couldn't believe how open he was. 31.7 seconds left to go. 14-12 is our score in favor of the visitors from Leland-Earlville. Coach Sandbrick's having a little discussion with the referee, pointing something out, maybe making him aware of something. Tate Anderson bringing it down. Picked up by Avilas. It's Marcus Avilas. 13 seconds. Gum, whoa, almost carried the ball, almost carried it. 5 seconds, they better hurry. 3 seconds left. He's gonna stop and pop and does not fall as Anderson took the last shot. It's off and no good. So at the end of one period of play, our score is Leland-Earlville 14, Hinckley-Big Rock 12. We'll be back right after this on TV 17 Sports.
Often forget about the people behind the snowplows who are out clearing the way for us in the worst winter conditions. Westside Truck stands behind these workers to repair and keep their trucks on the road no matter how high the snow piles up this winter. Hodges Westside Truck Center is the place to go if you need a work truck for your business. Hodges offers a wide variety of trucks to meet your needs, and we have two locations to serve you in Marengo and in Elburn. And that's where you can browse around and find the right truck for you. We also service what we sell. We have an excellent parts and customer service department, and we also have a complete workshop to make the repairs you need to keep your truck on the road. Our Elburn facility is located on Main Street just east of Route 47. And in Marengo, you can find Westside Truck Center on Route 20 Grant Highway near I-90.
And we're back at Hinckley-Big Rock High School, the place where the Harlem Globetrotters back in 27, Gary, played their first game. Anderson, yeah, Gary says he was there, at least in spirit. Number 33 in now, that is who? That's Taylor Rue. Back to Taylor. He's going to take that three-point shot, and he hits.
Whoa.
Right off the bench, and Taylor Rue with a three-point basket. And Hinckley's up 15-14. Velas. Intercept, well, almost intercepted. Ball on the floor. Picked up now. Taken back. Wenzel going to come all the way in, and he can't get it to fall to his Wenzel, I should say. Avilas now coming back. Avilas. Nice pass underneath, but there's a reach-in foul, looks like. Brech apparently was fouled. Cody picking up that foul. And Tyler's free throw is up and in. So Brech with 4 points. And back to a tie game, 15 up. Coming in now, number 45. Who was that, Gary? Curry Marker. So Marker's in the game. Second free throw, nice high arcing shot, and that's good. So Tyler with 5 points, and 16-15 is the score. 7 minutes left to go in the half. Nice pass. Ooh, he was underneath, but he dishes off, and that shot is no good, taken by Wenzel. Ball taken back now by Leland-Earlville. Nice drive to the hoop, and a basket there by Joey Avilas. He just strong dribble drive to the basket, and he makes it work. Rue with it. Wenzel back out to Anderson. Thought about the three. Good D there by Strahlka. It's all over him. Thought about the three again. Rue will take it. Oh, off. Rebound grabbed. And taken back by Avilas. Leland-Earlville, he'll try a three. Wide open, but can't get it to fall. Rebound. Almost lost, but taken back by Tate Anderson. Royals trail by a point. 6 minutes left to go in the half. Nice pass underneath. Can he get it to fall? No. Right, kind of a reverse layup and missed everything. Avilas now. Over to Marcus Avilas. Ball hit his pocket pick by Wenzel. Can he get the ball? It's struggling over. Held ball. So possession arrow to who, Gary? To Leland-Earlville, number two coming back in the game. That's Jacob Messicanus. All right, Messicanus, 18-15 our score. Leland-Earlville on the bonus now. Strahlka gonna pass off to Avilas. Brech sets a pick. Nice pass underneath the Brech, and is that a blocking foul or what? Are they going to call that a charge, Gary? What's a call? Yeah, it's a charge. Coach McGill not too happy with it, talking to the referee about it. And looks like Tyler had the wind knocked out as he struggles to get to his feet. Yeah. He had the wind knocked out. We're going to sit down for a little bit. And I got to check who came in for him. 23, Gary. Blaze Cancino in. Marker in the game now. Also, Marker's going to shoot. Can't get the three-pointer to fall, and Avilas grabs that long rebound. Leland coming down. There's a shot from the top of the key, and it's no good. Rebound grabbed there by the other Misakinas. That's Jake. And Anderson with it now. Marker. Oh, passed into Menzel. He can't hang on to it. Taken away there by number 23, Blaze Cancino. He gives it off to Avilas. He'll pop, and he scores. Joey Avilas with 6 points now. And we have a whistle and a timeout, so we will take a timeout. 20 to 15 is our score. 4:24 to go in the first half. Back after this on TV 17.
Fried food, but the problem is it's fried in oil. Lots and lots of oil. And that means added calories. But what if you could eat the fried foods you love with little to no oil, without the gills, and without the extra calories, but still have that great taste? Imagine mountains of piping hot French fries, crisp, snap-apart onion rings, golden fried chicken wings, guilt-free. Introducing the Power Air Fryer XL, the 6-in-1 revolutionary kitchen miracle with one-touch technology that fries with superheated cyclonic air with little to no oil and up to 80% less fat.
We're so sure you're going to love your Power Air Fryer XL, you can try it risk-free in your home for 60 days. If you don't absolutely love it, send it back for a refund, no questions asked.
This special offer will end without notice, so you must call or go online right now.
Do it or go 1-800-384-1549 or go to powerairfryer.com. This offer is not available in stores, so don't delay. Call now.
4:24 left to go in our first half here at Hinckley-Big Rock High School. Royals trail by 5, 20-15 to Leland-Earlville. Almost taken back. Menzel, nice drive to the hoop. So Matt with his first basket, and it's 20-17. Meanwhile, Leland-Earlville comes racing back. It looks like we're going to have a charge. Yes, we do. Out of control fouls, I like to call it. Gary points out the new term for that is player control foul. So Bryce Abbott with the foul. That's his second. 15 foul, actually 16 foul. One more foul for Leland-Earlville, and the Royals will be in the bonus. Tate Anderson brings it down. As we approach the 4 minute mark, and pass it. Taylor Rue into Menzel, and it's knocked away. Nice deflection there. And Avilas has the ball now. Into the corner, that's number 20 there now. In and out for the three-pointer, and that was Grant Campbell in the game. He was open. Coach told him to drive to the basket. So who do we have coming in here? Grant Cupler. Number 20 in the game for the Royals. Corey Marker also in the game. Nice pass. Rue going to pass it out. Anderson with it. Thought about it. Misakinas back out to Anderson. He's picked up by 3 point by Rue, and he hits it again. So Taylor Rue now with 6 points, and it's a 20-20 tie. Strzalka. Out to Avilas, pass underneath, nice move and nice basket. That was 23, Blaze Cancino with the basket. His first basket of the evening, and it's 22-20 in favor of Leland-Earlville. Taylor Ruth thought about it. Oh, they throw the ball away, that's across the timeline. Actually, I think it was deflected. So Gary says it was deflected. Okay, I missed that. So Royals maintain possession. 2:40 left to go here in the first half. Trailing by 2 points to Leland-Earlville. Parker thought about it. Rue has it. Rue consistently gets open for that three-pointer. Parker. We're going to try it again. Oh, and almost got it, but it goes out of bounds. And it goes over to Leland-Earlville. Some more substitutes coming in. Musicanus comes in. Marker goes out. Abelis hustles across the timeline. Picked up by the other Musicanus. Nice drive to the hoop and up and no good, but there's a push off. Pushing foul. Looks like Jacob, no, not Jacob. It's going to be Seth picking up that one. So in the bonus, so 1-1 here. Grant Campbell. Free throw in and out, no good, but they get the rebound. Nice hustle there by Stralka. Stepped on the timeline, but he was pushed. I think it was Taylor Root picking up that foul. They pass it in and turning around and can't get it. The foul was big number zero, Logan Stralka. Royals coming back. Anderson with it. Setting things up. Mr. Canis. Number 20's got it. Back out to Rue. Thought about it. Almost lost, and they do lose control of the ball. Campbell with it. Campbell driving it all the way. His shot, kind of a wild shot, didn't make it. Royals come running back. Anderson will try a three. He can't get it to fall off the backboard. Now running back is Sweeney. He's going to take it all the way. Knocked away. Nice rebound. Up and in. Stralka with the basket. Sweeney got, look, that popped in the nose there. Does he have a bloody nose there, Gary? He's going to have to come out. So 23 picking up that was Seth Misikanis. And big number zero, Logan Stralka gets a free throw. Three fouls now for Mr. Kane. He's going to have to come out. 1:18 left to go here. Referee telling Coach Sandbrooks what the story is. He's trying to make his point. He thought that was a block shot. I think the referees are a little bit confused, Gary.
Me too.
Gary says, me too. So that's no basket, it's a 1-1? Is that what they're going to say? You take points off the board or what? I got Stralka for four. They still have him up there. Okay. Stralka got the basket, and the foul was actually on number 31, Brennan Sweeney. So no chance for the three-point play, but Sweeney does get the 1-1. Understand that, Gary? Does that make sense? Yeah, they're going to count the basket. Bill Sandbrooks wants to know, does it count? They haven't taken it off yet. Still has 4 points. Free throw coming up now. And Sweeney gets it to fall. Brendan Sweeney with his first point of the evening. It's a free throw. 25-20 is our score. Second free throw, and that one's good as well. Sweeney with two free throws for his 2 points. 26-20 is our score. 1:12 left to go here in the first half. Anderson thought about it. And Taylor Root not afraid to put it up. In three-point land, that is. Anderson, back over to Rue. Anderson, a little spin move, going to take it to the hoop.
In and out and then back in again. So Tate Anderson with his first basket, and he steals it. Gets the ball back. What's he going to do? He's going to pass off. He's open for the three, so he'll take it. Ooh, off the front end of the iron. Rebound grab by Aviles.
30 seconds left to go. Aviles crosses the timeline. 26-22 is our score. Had the shot, just couldn't get it to fall. Cancino. Back out to Aviles. Sweeney had it. Or Estralka. Oh, Sweeney's going to drive it all the way. Wild shot goes in. Brendan, 4 points now. At the buzzer, no good. So at the half, our score, Leland-Earlville 28, Hinckley-Big Rock 22. We'll be back to check out the scoring and some other scores and highlights right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Whether you're a seasoned hunter or getting ready for your first hunt, you'll need to be prepared. JR Shooting Sports is your complete shooting sports retail center.
We can outfit the entire family, including ladies and youths.
We'll equip you for the hunting season with a full line of shooting accessories.
And don't forget about your hunting, buddy.
JR Shooting Sports has your dog training collars, scents, and retrieving dummies to give you every advantage out there. Visit JR Shooting Sports today, a mile west of the Fox Valley Mall on Oakhurst Drive in Aurora.
Welcome back to Hinckley-Big Rock High School. Our halftime score is 28-22 in favor of the Panthers of Leland-Earlville. Let's check our scoring real quick. For the home team Royals, they're led with by Taylor Rue with 2 3-point baskets. He's got 6 points. Seth Misukanis, he's got 4 points, a basket, and 2 free throws. Jake, his brother, Jake Misukanis, has 5 points. We also have 3 from Jackson Lauer, 2 from Matt Menzel, and 2 from Tate Anderson. For Leland-Earlville, they're led by Bryce Abbott. He's got 7 points. Joey Aviles has 6. Tyler Brech with 5. Blaze Cancino's got 2. Brennan Sweeney with 4. And Logan Stralka with 4 points. Once again, our halftime score, 28-22. Back with all the second half action. Right after this, you're watching TV 17 Sports.
Time is infinite. Why is there never enough of it? A John Deere 1 family tractor with Quick Park lets you attach and go. iMatch Quick Hitch makes implement hookups a snap and gives you more time for what you love. So it takes less work to do more work. Auto Connect Drive Over Mower Deck, done. They're not making any more land, but there's plenty of time if you know where to look. That's how we run, and nothing runs like a deer.
Welcome back to Hinckley-Big Rock High School. The Royals trail the Panthers 28-22. Panthers with 14 points in the first period, 14 in the second. Royals with 12 in the first period, 10 in the second. Outscored by 2 points and then 4 points. So they trail by 6. They have the ball and we're underway here in the second half. He's come with it. Misukanis going to take it to the hoop. No, he passes it off. Back out deep. Anderson will set it up again. Oh, pass. Hit him off the face. He took his eye off the ball, tried to make his move before he caught it. Yeah. Gary called that a face-off. Gary with another clever comeback. Stralka had it. Over to Brech. Nice move inside. Who's got it now? Hinckley's got it. Misukanis finally got the handle. Open for 3, and he hits. That's come with a 3-pointer. Drive to the hoop, there's a shot, it's in, and he's fouled. Bryce Abbott, nice basket, nice stop and pop, and he's fouled. So He gets the three-point play attempt. 30-25 is our score. Bryce with 9 points. Can he get number 10? Yes, he does. Got a friendly roll there. And he's got 10 points now, leads all scores. 31-25 is our score in favor of Leland-Earlville. Anderson fell down and he was pushed. Straka gonna pick up that foul. Anderson. He's picked up by Straka. Big number zero. They take it all the way down. Nice pass off. And it's gonna be a charging foul, no basket. Player control foul, as Gary corrected me. Panthers over to Sweeney, trying to get the ball out of their zone. Avilas with it, he's picked up. Over to Sweeney. He loses control, but he gets the ball off. And it's taken back by Anderson of the Royals. Thought about the three. He's going to drive it to the hoop, going to pass off. Man open at the corner. He'll try the three, and he hits. Number two, Jake Musicanus. That's his second three-pointer. He's got 8 points now, 31-28. Avilas across the timeline. Sweeney thought about it. Avilas will try the three, and he hits. Nothing but net. Joey with 9 points now, and it's 34-28. Both teams starting to hit from the outside. Nice pass underneath, and Seth was pushed, so he's going to get a couple free throws. Who pushed him, Gary? I didn't get the number. 31, Sweeney. Gary says the ref pushed him.
He's grounded.
Free throw is up and around, no good. Seth couldn't get that one to drop. He's got two free throws earlier in the ball game. 5:36 left to go here in the third period. Second free throw, that one too strong. Rebound grabbed though by Hinckley Big Rock. Nice pass underneath. Nice basket there. That's Lauer with that one. 5 points. Nice pass underneath. 34-32. Avilas gonna drive. He was open for a moment. Rebound grab by Musicanus. Anderson bringing it down now for the Royals. He's gonna take it all the way. Gonna drive in, and he's fouled. Now, will they consider that on the floor? Number 11 picked that one up. That was Bryce Abbott, so. The foul was on the floor, not in the act of shooting. There's a drive to the hoop off the front end of the board. And Anderson a little bit shaken up. It's a 5-on-4 here. Avilas open for the three, a little bit too strong. And underneath is Brech. He gets at the fall and he's fouled. So he gets the basket. 23, fourth foul now on Misicunas. Misicunas is gonna have to come out. Four fouls. Seth's got 4 points, but he's gotta come out. Coming in now is Marcus Avilas. Going out is Bryce Abbott. Brech will get a chance to pick up his 8th point. He's got 7. 36-30 is our score. Free throw is good. So Tyler with 7 points. Taylor Rue in. Probably need a 3-point shooter in there now. Come. Gets it back. We thought about it, but a nice pass, and the shot is up around and doesn't fall, but a nice rebound. They get it back. Nice floating shot, but it doesn't fall. It's knocked out of bounds by the Royals. So ball goes over to Leland-Earlville. Panthers up by 7, 37-30. Joey Aviles over to Marcus Aviles. Full court pressure there by Hinckley-Big Rock, but they break it. And the ball stolen. Taken back there. Bad pass, and the Royals grab it. They're rushing down court. Oh, there's a travel. He dragged his foot. He knew it. Sweeney will inbound the ball. Over to Aviles. To the other Aviles. Strelka. Back to Marcus Aviles. And a reach in foul. So Cody Gunn with his third foul. Long pass down to Aviles. He's wide open. He's going to take that shot. He hits. Count it, and a foul. So Marcus with his first basket. It's a three-pointer, and there was a foul underneath. No, they'll say that he was fouled, too, after he got the shot. No. Taylor Rue picked up the foul, and he fouled. Will not be a shooting foul. Okay. Because they're not in the bonus yet. They took the shot from the outside. Yeah, it was from away from the basket. Bill Sandbrooks would like an explanation with that. And what do we have here? Another foul? Okay, Corey Gum picking up another foul. He's got four fouls. He's going to have to come out. And we have Cameron Rumpf coming in the game for Gum. And Bill Sandbrooks will call a timeout, so we'll take a timeout. 3:46 left to go in the third period of play. 40-30, a 10-point lead for Leland-Earlville. We'll be back right after this on TV 17 Sports.
20 years, Pegs on Main Street in Maple Park has provided quality professional hair care for the entire family. Peg and her staff keep up on the latest fashion trends for adults and children. She also carries a wide variety of hair care products for your convenience. And when they're finished pampering your hair, you can walk over and browse around the fantastic on-site gift shop. Stop in anytime at Pegs on Main in downtown Maple Park or give them a call at 815-827-3051.
We're back at Hinckley-Big Rock High School where the Royals trail by 10 points now, 40-30. Leland-Earlville with the ball. Man wide open. He's on the line. That is not a three, it's a two. So Marcus Aviles picks up his fifth point and a quick foul by Taylor Rue. So it's a 12-point lead now. Just a few moments ago it was 34-30, it's 42-30 now. Eight straight points for Leland-Earlville, and they have the ball. Strelka, back over to Aviles, get another call. And this time it's against, looks like number 12, Tyler Bretsch. And he'll hold. How many fouls is that on him? He's got three fouls. A lot of people in foul trouble here, Gary. Romp. Over to Lauer. Rue's got it. Oh, bad pass. Take it back by Strelka. He's going to drive it. Take it all the way. Stops. Can't get the foul, but a nice rebound and a putback there by Tyler Bretsch. 44-30. Big hard pass underneath, and it goes out of bounds. was intended for Grant Cupler, but he couldn't handle it. Goes out of bounds and back over to Leland-Earlville. They're up by 14 now. Royals better do something in a hurry as the game's starting to slip away from them. Brett's coming off to the side. Now he gets back to join his teammates. Sweeney trying to pass in, finally does, and okay, the ref says that Avila stepped on the line. So the Royals will get the ball. Taylor Rue will inbound it. He looks like a catcher, doesn't he, Gary? His brother was a catcher on the baseball team, in addition to it being a basketball player as well. Jackson Lauer passes it off, gun back. And that ball goes out of bounds off of whose hands? Okay, last touch by the Royals. They couldn't handle it. Sweeney will inbound it. Gets it through Aviles. Double team. Oh, almost taken away. Almost stolen. Full court pressure here by the Royals. Nice move to the basket, and Strelka gets it to fall. Strelka with 6 points now, and it's a 16-point lead, and they steal the ball again. Strelka's got it, gonna drive it all the way. No foul. He misses the layup. Royals get it. Royals gonna have to put the ball up. Oh, nice dipsy to move there by Seth Misakinas, and he gets the basket, and it's 46-32. Panthers come right back. See if they run some clock. Joey Aviles with it. Thought about a nice pass underneath, and Sweeney all alone gets the basket. Brennan Sweeney's got 4 points. Almost lose it. Rue going to try that three-pointer, this time a little bit too strong. Sweeney grabs the rebound. And we have a whistle and a, looks like a timeout. So the Panthers will take a timeout. Our score, 48-32. 1:27 left to go in the third period, and we'll be back right after this on TV 17 Sports.
Well, there's cell phones, jewelry, TVs and baby clothes, computers, arcade games, MP3s and stereos, backpacks, jackets, toys and fresh produce, eye exams, appliances, rugs and cowboy boots, good food, drink, shades and pet accessories, fragrances, massages, hats, music, DVDs, custom shirts, beds, purses and socks galore, dresses, blankets, dollar items and so much more. Find anything from anywhere, from the common to the rare. There's good times to share at 7 Mile Fair. Opens at 9 until 5. Located in Caledonia, right off the I. Find anything from anywhere, from the common to the rare. There's good times to share at 7 Mile Fair. Opens at 9 until 5. Located in Caledonia, right off the I. Where weekends mean bargains, 7 Mile Fair.
1:27 left to go here in the third period of play. Royals trail by 16 to the Panthers of Leland-Earlville. And the Panthers have the ball. Marcus Aviles over to Brech. Whoa, Aviles, nice catch on that pass. Over to Marcus Aviles. Sweeney has it. Oh, had his pocket picked by Gum. Gum's going to take it all the way, and he's bumped. And Sweeney will pick up that foul. Stopped him from getting a layup, though, so that's what you call a good foul, right, Gary? Taylor Rue will inbound the ball. He's looking, looking, looking. It was Seth Misakinas had it. Back to Rue. Lauer with it. Pass over to Rue, over to the corner. Misakanis will drive and score. Seth now has 8 points. He's got to be careful. He's got the four fouls. 48-34 is our score. Avilas, 35 seconds left to go here in the third period. Joey Avilas going to pass underneath. Can Brech get it up and in? No. Grabs his rebound? No, can't grab it. But he will pick up a foul, though, as they battled underneath for that rebound. So how many fouls does he have now, Gary? He's got four fouls. Wow. All right, 23 seconds left to go in this third period. Rue's got it. Gets it back. Thought about the three. Panthers back in that zone. Back to Rue. He was open. He'll try his three. That one won't fall, and that will end our third period of play with our score. Leland-Earlville 48, Hinckley-Big Rock 34. Back with our final period of play right after this on TV 17 Sports.
Shift into savings now at your local Kubota dealer. Our Z700 series combines strength and stability with powerful transmissions, terrain-hugging wide-stance rear tires, and a low center of gravity. The professional-grade industrial-strength Z700 series will help you get the job done right every time. Now, during our Shift into Savings sales event, get zero down and 0% financing for 5 years. See your local Kubota dealer today.
We're back in our final period of play at Hinckley-Big Rock High School, where the Royals trail by 14 points. Have a whistle right away and a hold. I think that was on Jackson Lauer. No, Matt Menzel. No, Menzel's not in the game. Yes, he is. No, he's not. Who's that foul on, Gary? Anyway, they're in the bonus now. Well, wait a minute. They have six fouls down. Okay, got to add another foul. Come on, we're waiting. There it goes. Looking at the scoreboard. So Joey Vilas gets a free throw. If he makes it, he gets another one, and he makes the first one. That's his first free throw of the evening. And he's got 10 points now. Gets to try a second free throw now. And no time has elapsed, by the way. Nice rebound by the Royals. Now the clock striking down. Taylor Rue thinking about it. The Royals taking too long to get their shot. Wide open for the three. Royals grab the rebound, though. When you take that three-pointer, a lot of times you get that hard, long rebound. Nice pass underneath. Rue will try a three-pointer. And we have a foul underneath. Who pushed off? I think they're going to call it on. Oh. So 31, that's Brennan Sweeney. So we've got Cameron Rumpf going to shoot a couple, well, at least one on the bonus if he makes it. Can't get at the ball. Royals give up the ball as Leland-Earlville. Nice move and nice basket there by Bryce Abbott. Abbott with 11 points, 12 points. 51-34, 17-point game. Rue's going to try another three. That one too strong as well. Goes out of bounds and last touched by Romp. So the Panthers get it back. 7 minutes to go in this ball game. Full court pressure there by the Royals. Sweeney going to pass over to the corner. Looks like he traveled. Yes, he did. Who was that? Number 23, Blaze Cancino. Shuffled his feet as he tried to start his move to the basket for an easy layup, but got called for the traveling. Royals. Cross court, romp with it, back over to Rue. Nice move, and can't fall there by Jackson Lauer. Rebound grabbed by Leland-Earlville. Panthers. Gonna run some clock now. 6:15 left to go in the ballgame. 51-34 is our score in favor of Leland-Earlville. Back out, around the horn. Nice drive to the hoop again by Abbott, and he scores. Unofficially have him for, what, 13, Gary? 53-34, 19-point lead. Outscoring them 19-4 in the past 8 minutes. Nice basket there by Seth Misikunas. He's got 10 points. 53-36 our score. Marcus Savilas thought about it. Joey thought about it. Had his pocket pick. Gum grabs it. Nice pass. Ooh. Can't get the layup to drop. Savilas brings it back. He'll drive all the way in. Nice rebound underneath, and Cancino can't get a foul. Gets it again, and he's fouled. Went up three times and finally fouled, looks like, by Rue. Let's see. Who got the foul there, Gary? So Rue picks it up, his second foul. Cancino will put his first free throw up and in. Nothing but net. So Cancino with 3 points now, a basket and a free throw. Second free throw coming up now, and that one also, in and out. Looked like Abbott went over the top, but referee says it was last touched by who? By one of the Royals. Okay, it was inbounded by Sweeney to Avilas, and his three-point shot hits off the iron, goes out of bounds, and will be kept there by Leland-Earlville. Avilas picked up by Menzel. Abbott over to Strolka. Bretch gonna take it to the hoop, puts it up, a little bit too strong. Rebound grab by who? Strolka. Abbott's got it, gonna move it back out. Clock running down, 4:40 left to go in the ball game. 18-point lead. Ooh, no foul there. Shot from the outside, rolls around, no good. Rebound grabbed by the Royals. Nice pass, drive to the hoop, scoop shot up and in by Seth Misikunas. Yes, he's got 12 points now. Strolka, gonna try to pass Avilas. Avilas got it. Back out to Strolka. Abbott. Got a foul picked up there by Menzel. So Matt picks up his second foul. 4 minutes to go. And Avilas will get some free throws. And let's see, that's 19 fouls so far for the Royals. One more, it'll be the super bonus. Free throws up and in. Joey Avilas with 11 points. Second free throw is good. And we have a timeout, so coaches call timeout. We will too. 4 minutes left to go. 56-38 is our score. Back after this.
Love fried food, but the problem is it's fried in oil. Lots and lots of oil. And that means added calories. But what if you could eat the fried foods you love with little to no oil, without the guilt, and without the extra calories, but still have that great taste? Imagine mountains of piping hot French fries, crisp, snap-apart onion rings, golden fried chicken wings, guilt-free. Introducing the Power Air Fryer XL, the 6-in-1 revolutionary kitchen miracle with one-touch technology that fries with superheated cyclonic air with little to no oil and up to 80% less fat.
We're so sure you're going to love your Power Air Fryer XL. You can try it risk-free in your home for 60 days. If you don't absolutely love it, send it back for a refund, no questions asked.
This special offer will end without notice, so you must call or go online right now.
Do it or go 1-800-384-1549 or go to powerairfryer.com. This offer is not available in stores, so don't delay. Call now.
4 minutes left to go in our ball game. Leland-Earlville up big, 56-38 over the Royals of Hinckley-Big Rock. Royals have the ball. Got to get something going right now. If they have any kind of a, probably going to have to start smoking from the three-point range. Romp, back out to Gum. Oh, little dipsy-doo shot there by number two, Jake Misikinas. It's a basket, 56-40 is our score. A lot of pressure now by the Royals. Ball tipped up in the air, grabbed by Aviles. Nice move to the hoop, no call there. But a nice rebound by Brech, and he puts it back in. Nice putback. And Coach Sandbrook's going to call another timeout. So we will take one, two, 3:09 left in the ball game. Back after this.
Hodges Westside Truck Center is the place to go if you need a work truck for your business. Hodges offers a wide variety of trucks to meet your needs. And we have two locations to serve you, in Marengo and in Elburn. And that's where you can browse around and find the right truck for you. We also service what we sell. We have an excellent parts and customer service department, and we also have a complete workshop to make the repairs you need to keep your truck on the road. Our Elburn facility is located on Main Street just east of Route 47, and in Marengo, you can find Westside Truck Center on Route 20 Grant Highway near I-90.
58-40 is our score in favor of Leland-Earlville. 3:09 left to play in this ball game. Royals have the ball. Trailing by 18. Another nice shot. This one doesn't fall. Nice rebound grab there by Abbott. Aviles double teamed, is in trouble. And he gets some help. Gets it back now. Oh, over and back. Little turnover. Panther coach can't believe it. Over and back call. He says, I don't believe it. Actually, it didn't look like it. Marker with it. Three-point shot from the corner. Long rebound grabbed, though, by the Royals. Marker, nice pass underneath. Can he get it to fall? No. Goes for the rebound. Big battle for the ball, and Brech comes up with it. Abbott with it. Tried to pass it in, and he gets it back. Lost control, but he got it back, and going to call a double dribble there, Gary. So ball goes over back to the Royals. 2:13 left to go in our ball game. 18-point lead. Nice little soft shot, and it's up and in. Misikinas, Jake Misikinas. He's got 12 points. And a foul is called. Who's this one on? Okay, Jacob Misikinas, his second foul. Super bonus now. Two free throws automatically. That's Brandon Sweeney. He's got 6 points unofficially. And that one rolls around and in. Got some help from the rim. His head ball clanged off a couple times, but it fell through. Second free throw now, and that one is up, and that one a little bit too strong, and a little lane violation there, Gary. Lane violation, so he's going to get another free throw. Here we go. Three to make two. Makes it. So Sweeney with 8 points. And it's a 60-42 game. Rue in the corner. 3-point shot. It's in. 24. Romp with his first basket. It's a 3-pointer. And we have a timeout. So our score is 60-45. 1:47 left to go. And we'll be back right after this on TV 17 Sports.
A long weekend is just an excuse to get a long way from boring. With models up to 62 horsepower or room for four. Go rugged. Go big. Go Gator.
Hi, I'm Dave Gieske from Buck Brothers in Hampshire. We have three other locations to serve you: Harvard, Wakanda, and Libertyville.
Welcome back to Hinckley-Big Rock High School, where the Royals trail by 15. Bodies all over the place, but the Panthers keep control of the ball. Avila's going to cross the timeline. See if they run some clock. Yes, they do. Got a foul. And he does. He's out of there. So Cody Gum is gone. That's his fifth foul. Who's coming in for the Royals? Let's see. Marker. Corey Marker coming in. So Sweeney gets a couple free throws. Super bonus time. His first shot is up and in, nothing but net. And Brennan's got 5 free throws tonight. Second free throw, and that's good. 62-45 is our score. Rue brings it down very quickly. Nice pass underneath, up and in. That was Seth with that basket, Seth Misakanis, and he's fouled, so a chance for that 3-point play. Seth has 14 points. Let's see. Gretch kind of got it. I believe he fouled out, number 12. 1:25 left to go in the ball game. Chance for the 3-point play here. Let's see if he can do it. And he does. Seth has 3 free throws tonight.
He only gets one.
One of the fans goes, he only gets one, which is true. What they could give him another one for? Oh, lost the ball, but it's nice. Johnny on the spot there is number 31, Sweeney. What are they going to call it? Double team. And Panthers call the timeout. We'll take the, no, we'll keep it right here, Gary. As the Panthers call the timeout to keep possession of the ball. We've got 1:16 left to go in the ball game. Leland-Earlville up 62-14, a 14-point lead. Panthers looking to go 9-11 on the season and 2-4 in conference. If the Royals lose, they're going to drop to 3-4 in conference and 4-15 overall. So far, the game's gotten progressively worse for them. 48, let's see, 14 points already scored. Gary's trying to figure out which songs are playing on the PA system. He says his band played this song. Is this like Duran Duran? Hungry Like the Wolf playing in the background. I know, Gary's hungry. Why don't you go out to eat after the game? He's hungry like a wolf. Panthers going to inbound the ball. Avila's going to, no, they didn't foul him. Thought they would. Playing keep away now. Trying to run out the clock. There's the foul right here. Marker going to pick up that foul. So Marker picks up his, what, first foul. Okay. Two free throws coming up. Let's see, Joey Vilas has how many points, Gary? 12 points. Make it 13. Second free throw coming up. Makes them both. 64-48. Time running down. Rue, nice pass in and shot from the corner. Up and in, three-pointer. This one by Jake Misakunas. And we have another timeout. So with the score 64-51, we will take one too. Back after this on TV 17 Sports.
HBR Shooting Sports is your complete shooting sports retail center with a full line of shooting accessories and Winchester ammunition.
We have the widest selection of high quality over and unders and the knowledgeable sales staff to pick out the right one for you. We carry a wide range of Winchester loads, including pistol shooting, upland bird, and steel for waterfowl.
Try the most reliable ammunition available from Winchester on our computerized shooting range. Visit JR Shooting Sports today, a mile west of the Fox Valley Mall on Oakhurst Drive in Aurora.
Welcome back to Hinckley-Big Rock. 50.4 seconds left to go in this ball game. Avilas has it. Sweeney's going to be fouled right away. Cameron Rump picked up the foul. Two free throws coming up. You're going to hope that he misses one of them and hope you can get a three-point basket. Or a three-point play, at least. Sweeney has been fairly accurate from the free throw line tonight. But I jinxed him when I said that. He has six free throws so far. I think he's missed three times. Second free throw is good. So he's just hitting about 70% now, Gary. Seven free throws. 65-51. Three-point shot. That one's no good. Rebound grab. Avila's going to get bumped, but no foul. Over to Cancino. And they're going to foul the wrong guy here, Avila's. He's got five free throws so far. Yeah. 14-point lead with 27.6 seconds left to go in this ball game. Joey Vilas will put up the first free throw, and it's nothing but net. Joey unofficially got him with 15. Second free throw is also good. Gotta take the three. Marker, and a pass off, 3-point, that's blocked in. A nice put back there by Seth. Grabbed that loose ball and he scored. 67-53 all alone, but he's gonna pull it back out and let the clock run out. And that'll be our ball game. Final score, 67-53 in favor of the Panthers. We'll be back with the wrap-up right after this on TV 17 Sports.
20 years, Pegs on Main Street in Maple Park has provided quality professional hair care for the entire family. Peg and her staff keep up on the latest fashion trends for adults and children. She also carries a wide variety of hair care products for your convenience. And when they're finished pampering your hair, you can walk over and browse around the fantastic on-site gift shop. Stop in anytime at Peg's on Main in downtown Maple Park, or give them a call at 815-827-3051.
Welcome back to Hinckley-Big Rock High School, where the Royals went down to defeat. They lose this game, final score 67-53 in favor of the Panthers of Leland-Earlville. Let's check our scoring real quickly for the Royals. They were led by Seth Misukanis with 17 points. Jake Misukanis had 14. They also got 5 points from Jackson Lehrer, 3 points from Cameron Romp on a three-point basket, Coda Gum with a three-point basket, Taylor Rue with a couple three-point baskets for his 6 points, and Tate Anderson with a basket late in the first half for the 53 points for the Royals. For the victorious Panthers, they were led by 16 points by Joey Aviles. They got 12 from Tyler Bretsch before he fouled out. They got 14 by Bryce Abbott, 11 from Brendan Sweeney, including 7 free throws near the end of the game. They also picked up 6 points from Logan Stroka, 5 from Marcus Aviles, and 3 from Blaise Cancino for their 67 points. Panthers improved their record to 9-11 on the season, 2-4 in conference. Royals fall to 3-4 in conference, and 14-15 overall. So our final score once again, Leland-Earlville 67, Hinckley-Big Rock 53. We thank you for joining us here tonight. For Gary Levitt, I'm Terry Weedle. Thank you for watching. See you next week up in Hampshire.